Private, there's a strong possibility that you'll encounter a T-47 there. It's Skynet's newest walker-type HK. If you can, take a photo of a functioning unit that we can analyze. Over and out.
gotta be Colin's hideout. Looks like Colin rigged this place with traps. Better be careful. There has to be a hospital nearby. Thank you.
Thank you.
sending you the first set of pictures.
That's exactly what we need. Move to the second point.
Dispensary. This is it.
Looks like Colin was really prepared.
Huh. Aaron will appreciate that. Commander, I've encountered Skynet's plasma storage.
You have a green light to destroy any Skynet structures in Pasadena. But keep in mind, that is not your highest priority. If you want to save ammo, overloading the main computer at any storage facility will do the trick.
Sending it right now.
Well done, Private. Now proceed with your main objective.
T-47 neutralized.
Thank you.
sign. That has to be Jennifer's house. Jennifer's father. Poor guy. Empty. Now where's the rest? Huh. Is that a map to your hiding place, Patrick? Thank you. position you've got there, Patrick. Okay, that should do it. Thank you. storage destroyed.
Good to hear, Rivers. Now proceed with your mission.
Thank you. Jacob, how is Pasadena? You know what? Forget I asked. I don't want to know. I'm just glad that you're all right.
And how are you doing?
I guess I'm a little nervous before tomorrow.
I never asked you. What are you planning to do tomorrow?
I've been meaning to tell you earlier, but I panicked. And that's because I decided to go with Ryan. We'll find somewhere safe, away from all this. You have to understand, I need to do what's best for Patrick. I'm his big sis. I need to protect him. I haven't told him yet. He'll be devastated leaving you and Aaron, but I think it's for the best.
Aren't you curious about what happened in Pasadena?
No. I think I'd rather keep that place in the past. Actually, I have a confession to make. I've never been outside of Pasadena until now. Can you believe that?
That's not surprising. After all, that's where your home is.
Where it used to be. Right now, I'm going to try someplace new to call home. I did my traveling through pictures and postcards that wanderers brought with them. My favorite had a little flamingo drinking water from a lake on it. Its long red neck curved like a snake. Patrick's mother gave me that postcard. It's funny how I never met my mother, but I was around to see Patrick's leave him.
I'm sorry to hear about your mother.
Don't be. I had a pretty good childhood, apart from the nuclear holocaust and all. I remember the day Patrick's mom brought him in. They were both tired and dirty, so we took care of them. Patrick was crying a lot. He was teething at the time. I think that was what scared her away. She just couldn't handle the crying.
I guess I'd be scared too.
Would you? You seem so composed. I even started wondering if you were a machine yourself. After she took off, I was devastated. But my father said, "You need to grow up. You have a brother now." So I burned the postcard. The little red flamingo flew up in flames. And I promised myself I'd never be weak again. But I guess we all need someone we can be weak with sometimes, don't we?
Wake up! We need to move.
What's going on?
Everyone, wake up! You need to get out of here.
Who the fuck are you?
It doesn't matter. What matters is that you can't stay here any longer.
She asked a question, and I suggest answering.
You don't want to do that. I've got this place rigged with explosives, and there's a detonator in my pocket.
You got what?
Would you mind? Lower your gun, Ryan. He's the one that saved my life. What do you want from us? You have to get out of here. Skynet's on its way. They finally found you.
What do you mean they found us? They were looking for us?
Not for you. For him. He's essential to winning this war. Skynet knows that. That's why they've been following him for months. I have to make sure nothing happens to him. In a couple of minutes, an infiltrator will walk in here trying to kill him. I can't let that happen. We have to bury that Terminator here once and for all.
All right, everybody, you heard him. Let's get moving. I'll get the bus ready.
There's no time for that. There's a passage here. It will lead you out. Use it.
What was that?
All right, everyone, get out!
Jacob!
Give me that. It's the same one. It's the same model. Leave! Now!
How the hell's he still alive?
Go! 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 Watch out! Don't just stand there! Run!
listen to us. She could no longer deny that this infiltrator was a real threat. She decided to take everyone in, on her terms. The shelter was on high alert, but thanks to the intel I gathered in Pasadena, we slowed the advance of the Annihilation Line and gained some time. Just enough to start preparing the counterattack.
Sergeant?
At ease.
Well, look at you, Sergeant. When you helped us in Pasadena the other day, I was trying really hard not to panic because you were only a private. Sorry for underestimating you. I guess I should salute or something?
How's Patrick?
Every day a little better. Aaron says he'll be back on his feet in no time. She's done a great job with him. I wish I could repay her somehow. It just doesn't seem that she needs anything.
Getting ready for another scavenging run?
No, I just came out here to catch my breath. Baron is giving us the entire evening off, believe it or not.
Doesn't sound like her. I need to report to Baron.
Rivers, DN 46890.
The commander is expecting you in the control room, Sergeant.
Maraschino Cherenzy. Where do they keep finding this shit?
I don't get it. How did they bring that buggy down here?
Hey, I'm just catching up with Mark. I'll get back to work in a couple of minutes. You won't tell, right? But no, seriously, you won't tell, right?
I'm going out soon. I haven't made my daily quota yet. I still have 3 more rats to catch. If you see one, let me know, okay?
Do you need anything?
Can I see your hardware?
Me? Honey, I'm about the most well-adjusted person in this goddamn place. It's the others you should be concerned about.
You mean Ryan?
Ryan ain't so hot either, but that's another story.
Jennifer?
I'm worried about her. I'm the one that asked Baron to give her team a little break. Jennifer's been busy scavenging supplies for the soldiers, and she hardly had time to see Patrick. And now she's finally got a day off. She's avoiding him like the plague.
How's Patrick doing?
He's fine, but it wouldn't kill you if you checked on him yourself.
Is there anything you need?
No. I have to say, the Resistance is pretty well supplied. Don't tell me you miss running errands for me. I don't believe that for a second.
And what about something other than medicine?
Honey, I'm not shy. I'll let you know if I need anything, okay? But thank you for asking.
Take care. How are you doing?
Good. Aaron's going to let me leave in a couple of days. Thanks for bringing that chalk. I've been drawing a lot. I'd be so bored without it.
How do you like living in the shelter?
There's a lot of people here. I like that. I heard a funny joke yesterday. You want to hear it?
Yeah, tell me.
What's brown and sticky? A stick!
That's funny.
I know, right?
How's Jennifer?
She's out a lot, but I understand. She's a scavenger.
I have to go.
Spider scout again.
Man, I saw it crawling through the shelter earlier. Almost gave me a heart attack.
You wanted to see me.
You're finally here. Good. I have a special task for you. I want you to head downtown to check on the doctor.
Doctor?
Alvin. He's out there making sure that our defense systems are working properly. Ever since we went radio silent, I had a small team of trustworthy messengers maintaining communication between our outposts. They haven't returned, so I want you to go downtown and see why that happened. Could be nothing. But Connor doesn't want any hiccups while he's up there in North Division preparing the attack on Skynet's central core.
Is there a problem with the radio?
The Annihilation Line is within spitting distance of downtown. We suspect that Skynet will be intercepting all transmissions from that location. So for now, we're going radio silent. That's why I need you to go there personally.
Central Core?
Skynet's main reactor. The source of all their power. We shut down the Central Core, we shut down Skynet. Connor's preparing the attack as we speak. So you understand we can't have any critical complications at this stage.
If you don't mind me asking, how did you end up here?
Excuse me if I act a little surprised, Sergeant. But no one in here thinks it's wise to ask their superior personal questions. But since you did, I'll humor you. So, how did I get here? The same way you did. I was born, raised, and given a gun. We don't really have a say in what we do, do we? Or do I assume too much? Was it any different for you? Why do you fight, Sergeant?
We don't have a choice.
Exactly. We're just going through the motions. Humans were fighting humans since the beginning of time. It just so happens that right now we have a common enemy. If it wasn't for the machines, we'd probably be fighting each other.
So, I guess we should thank the machines for teaching us compassion.
I guess we should. I have my special way of thanking them. Shot to the skull from a plasma rifle. Besides, I'm not a fighter. When I go out there in the middle of the night with my Westinghouse, I'm not looking for a fight. I look to seek and conquer. I'm not a fighter. I'm a bully.
What's the difference?
I don't treat them as equals. And although I know they're just machines, I want them to fear me. No one ever stands up to bullies. But I have to admit, it has its downsides. One of them being that no one ever asks me a personal question. At least not since Perry died. So congratulations, Rivers. Takes guts to stand up to a bully. I guess since your promotion, you got a little more cocky. Good for you.
Hey, Ryan. How's everything?
Exactly as you would imagine. Baron's keeping me busy. They weren't kidding when they said she's a hard ass.
What did you hear?
A lot of rumors going around of how she's sending insubordinate workers to the front line. And by insubordinate, I mean people who ain't willing to work 18 hours a day. Every day.
What happened after you started your camp?
Honestly? Not that much. At least not in the beginning. When we gave up on the idea of getting in touch with anyone, we just tried to adapt. Temperatures fell, we had to scavenge for food. All of a sudden, that became our life.
Didn't you try to reach home?
Some people did. Most of us were scared of what we'd find if we did get home, so we conveniently said we're stranded here anyways and stayed. Well, I know how stupid it sounds, but we managed to have fun in our little commune. I still had my guitar with me. We talked a lot about how we're gonna be famous, because we're the only living band in the world.
What was your band's name?
Well, we were thinking about changing it to Survivors, but something similar was already taken. We were just stupid kids, not realizing what was going on. We paid the price for it the first time we saw a tin can. I was tuning my guitar when I heard a strange noise. I found out later that it was a T-400. Must have heard me play. It didn't even have the decency to look scary. Maybe if it did, we wouldn't have just stood there when it started firing.
What did you do?
I froze. I didn't run to help. I didn't scream. I didn't even move. I just stood there, like a coward. A tin can got Tucker with a single bullet. Bang, just like that. Seven other people died before we finally destroyed that thing. Ironically enough, I was the one who delivered the final blow. Safe to say, it was the beginning of a new era.